This is the first film in the rebooted Planet of the Apes series since 20th Century Studios was bought by the Walt Disney Company. It's Kingdom of the Planet of the Apes, and we are going to talk about it right after this. Hey everybody, Mikeylito here with another matinee review. This week's feature is Kingdom of the Planet of the Apes. It is the fourth film in the rebooted Planet of the Apes series, but as I mentioned during the intro, it is the first film produced since the Walt Disney Company bought 20th Century Fox. This is a direct sequel to the third film in the series, War of the Planet of the Apes. However, aside from some opening scenes, this film takes place many generations, we are told, after that film. Now, there's going to be some mild spoilers of the opening sequences of this film, maybe like the first 25%, but we're not going to spoil anything that hasn't been seen in the trailers if you've seen the trailers. So let's talk about it, shall we? This is Noah, a chimpanzee of the Eagle Clan. It's a clan of apes that raises eagles as servant companions. Now, what I mean by that is the eagles gather fish for the clan to eat and otherwise accompany the apes for hunting and defense. Now, as the story opens, Noah and two other chimps, Anaya and Suna, are climbing up to raid eagle eggs from nest. I guess in human terms, you could say that these three are teenagers. As a rite of passage, they are supposed to gather an egg to raise an eagle to become adult members of the clan. When the trio returns home, Noah detects a scavenger in their midst, and he has a brief encounter with a human female who has been following Noah around. In that encounter, Noah's egg is broken, and he is forced to go off on his own to acquire another egg. While traveling, Noah runs into a rogue clan led by Proximus Caesar, who bears no relationship to Caesar from the original three films of the reboot series in either bloodline, beliefs, or temperament. His general is Silva, who's equally vicious and brutal. They spot Noah's dismounted horse and chase him to Noah's village, meaning chasing the horse to the village. By the time Noah arrives, the village is in flames. Noah's father is soon dead, and the rest of Noah's clan is taken captive while he is knocked unconscious. When Noah awakens, he leaves the destroyed village and tries to track where his clan was taken. Along the way, he meets up with an orangutan named Raka, who explains the real origins of the apes and the ways of the original Caesar. Meanwhile, the human scavenger crawls to the edge of their camp, but Raka convinces Noah to give the human food and a blanket. Eventually, the two apes and the human start traveling together. As the human, to the ape's surprise, can speak, she says her name is May. And she tells them she knows where Proximus has taken Noah's clan. While they travel, the trio finds other humans, and Noah decides to split from May and Raka. Just as he leaves them behind, Proximus, Silva, and their clan attack the humans as they try to escape. Noah rescues May and is rejoined with Raka, And the three continue on their journey. That's about as much as I'll go into the plot as those scenes are seen in the trailer. I'll be the first to admit that based on the trailers, I had expectations as to what the film was about. So I didn't do what I would normally do, which is to watch the three prior films in the series so that I would have some continuity going forward. The overall story from beginning to end wasn't bad, but I had expectations of seeing more interaction between humans and apes. The only other human that was in the film was William H. Macy as a character named Trevathan. I don't have a photo of him, and we don't see very much of him in the film, although he was somewhat of a pivotal character, if ever so briefly. What did I think of the film overall? I'm giving Planet of the Apes right now a 6 out of 10. That's the equivalent of 3 out of 5 stars. To me, based on the complete film, it kind of came off as a money grab. The film, which has no mid-credit scene or post-credit scene, is basically just a setup for more films. At least that's the way that I feel. So we'll just have to see where it goes. I've talked to some other people. If you like Planet of the Apes films, by all means, go see it in the theater. But for me right now, I would just recommend that you wait and see it on Hulu. The choice is yours. It's entirely up to you. So, as I always say, watch content, form opinion. You just heard mine. I'd like to hear yours. To be honest, what I'm going to do this weekend is I'm going to rewatch the first 3 films in the series. And based on what I see in those films and what I know of this film, I may reevaluate it. And if I do, you'll hear about it on my next broadcast. Which, speaking of which, now that next broadcast might be next Friday. Furiosa, a Madman's Saga hits theaters next Thursday and Friday. However, Thursday, I have a medical procedure. So I may not be in the condition or the mood to see this film. So I do have a ticket for it. But watch my Twitter X feed at MikeylitoLIVE, and that will I will let you know sometime Friday whether or not I'm going to see that film. If I do, the review will be Friday evening at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific, and 11 p.m. Greenwich Mean Time. Regardless of whether or not I see Furiosa, the next film I will be seeing in June is Bad Boys Ride or Die. And I'll be reviewing it Friday, June 7th at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific, and 11 p.m. Greenwich Mean Time. Meanwhile, take 3 minutes and watch the rest of the movie calendar for 2024. Now, the films that are highlighted in yellow are the films that I will be definitely planning on seeing and reviewing. But this is everything that I could find in the movie calendar for 2024. So take 3 minutes and watch this. As always, please comment down below and like and share this video. Subscribe to the channel at Mikeylito Live. And you can find me on these social media outlets and on my leisure blog at Mikeylito.blog and my opinion blog at Mikeylito.com. So until next Friday, let's keep our fingers crossed, or Friday, June 7th, when it would be Bad Boys Ride or Die. This is Mikeylito saying thanks for watching. Again, watch the Twitter X account to find out whether we're going to be on next Friday or Friday, June 7th is our next broadcast. Whichever one, stay safe, be well, and thanks for watching. Mikeylito saying ciao for now.